What is up, guys? Today I got this tutorial and we will create some half underwater, half above water scene. So you will learn how to make the surface look like that and do some lighting in the water and all the good stuff. So let's just jump right into it. Okay, I'm gonna create a white screen here. So this is okay, and this will be our water, so I'm just gonna copy this. Just the water here, so just select this and copy it. Paste it in this file. Convert to smart object and resize it. And we need to flatten this a little bit, so I'm just holding down shift, and I'll hold it down shift, I'll just bring this down so we have this surface a little bit flattened like that, maybe a little bit more. And let's create a new layer here, and this will be our water, so I'm just gonna select something blue here. Fill it with this color. Now let's put this on top and let's create a mask. Now we're gonna get rid of these parts, so I'm just gonna select the normal brush here. So just select the general brush, soft round, and bring up the hardness, because we don't want a soft edge, we want a hard edge here. And zoom in a little bit, and let's get rid of this piece. Make sure you select the black brush and not the white one. Let's first make a right line, so I just hold it down shift, and that's too much, and like this, bring this piece back. So holding down shift and get rid of this like that. Now I want to create some waves here, so it isn't like horizontal, so I'm just gonna select the white brush and create like these little waves here, so we don't have a straight line, because you won't have a straight line in the water, so just need a little bit of waves here like that. Now let's see, this is our sky, just gonna copy this and paste it behind all the layers. Make a smart object. Press Ctrl T to resize it and resize it all. So we have this nice sunset in the background. I think this is fine. Now we can even stretch this a little bit more. So I'm just gonna move this up, because we don't need that much from this surface. I want some more space here so we can create stuff in the water. So this is fine, and let's stretch this a little bit like that. Now I'm gonna use this as an underwater image, so I'm just copying this and paste it here. Make a smart object and resize this again, so we can use all these details from underwater here. You can hold down shift and stretch it like that. And let's put this in a folder. This is underwater. Now, hold down Control and select this. Go to this layer and make a mask. So we're only using that area. Can even flatten this more. Like that. Now let's blend in these colors. So let's put this in a folder. This is our water. I'm gonna go create a hue and saturation here. Press this so it only affects this layer underneath it. And let's move this a little bit down. A little bit more green and more color like that. And also the same for this. Hue saturation layer, press this again. And remove all these colors. A little bit more turquoise, not so much blue. And let's do the same here. Like that. And let's also do the sky. Let's blend the sky better with these images. So I'm just gonna create a folder for this. This is our sky. Drag it in this folder and create the hue saturation again. Select this and drop these colors. All right, this looks fine for now. And let's see, maybe need to even flatten this more. All right, I'm gonna leave it like that for now. Now, this is our wheel, so I'm just copying this. Put it above all the other layers, and don't forget to make a smart object again, so we don't ruin the quality of the image. Let's put this in a folder. Wheel, and press Ctrl T to transform it, and let's rotate it so we can make like this side sticking out of the water. But I still want to see his eyes, so I want to make sure his eyes are not on this area, but either here or here. So just gonna make sure it's underwater. Probably something like that. If I make this bigger. Not sure about this quality, it's not so really good. So you can see there is like a white line around this image, so I want to get rid of that first. So I'm just gonna make sure it's in this image now. Now while holding down Control, click on this wheel layer so it makes this selection. Now go to select modify contract, and with this function you can like select one or two pixels less from this selection. So just gonna select two. So you see it's now selected 2 pixels inside this image. So with this selection you can just select mask, and let me show it again. So this selection, select mask, and we got rid of all that white, all those white lines around it. So this is fine now, and let's put this in a place. Now I want to create 2 layers here, so we can have 1 layer for this part underwater and 1 layer for this part, so we can separately adjust them. So I'm just gonna drag it to here. So we're copying this layer. Now let's disable one of those. This will be our top part. So I'm just gonna quickly remove this. So select this area, press D on your keyboard so you can make this black, and just select the mask of it, press Control Backspace, and now we can make this part like not straight but maybe some little waves so it looks more real. So this will be his head will be sticking out, or we can even do it like this. make sure to select both layers. So we only have this part sticking out. So I'm just gonna do this again, select this and delete most of it. And just brush these parts with hardness like around 80-90. So it isn't too soft, but it also isn't too hard. So like these waves here. That, and let's do the same here, but the other way around. So just gonna get rid of this part. And make sure it's like on this line here from the wave. So we can drop the opacity so we can see it better. Make it just going around this line here. Like that, and let's bring this back. We can even do a little bit more here because he's a little bit too close now. Like that. And now we can easily adjust this part, so you can either drop the opacity to make it look more real, or we can just select right mouse and go to blending options. And let's do some color overlay here, like he's underwater, and pick something dark blue. Change the blend mode overlay. Oh, that's a little bit too blue, so just select this water and pick some color so it isn't the same as this part. I'll just play around with these colors until you get something that fits best. You can even do soft light here. Alright, I'm gonna leave it like that and slightly drop the opacity. So we have a little bit of opacity here. Okay, now I wanna create a little white line here so we can see the surface better. So I'm just gonna create a new layer. Zoom in here and select the white color. Bring the hardness around 50, I think, here, and make like this line around this whole surface here. So just go from left to right. Now it's a little bit too thick, this line, so just gonna Ctrl T and like that, make it smaller and blur it out a little bit. So just go to blur, Gaussian blur. Just a little bit of blur. Like that, and drop the opacity. So you can see the surface better. You can try to even make this smaller. Just a little line, those little details do matter. So this is before and this after. So you can clearly see where the water ends. And if it's not so nice like here, we can always just select this layer from the surface of the water and just brush these parts away. Okay, I think this is fine. All right, I'm gonna brush this a little bit more because it looks like he's a little bit too close to this camera. So I'm gonna brush this and remove some more from this part. so it looks more real if it's a little bit far from the camera. You can always just take some parts. All right, this is fine for now, and let's do some details in the water. This is our surface line. Let's put this above these layers. Now let's see, this is our underwater layer. I want to create some lighting here, so I'm just going to create a new layer above our wheel. And select some lighting brushes. I have all these brushes in the description if you want to download them. So I'm just going to use one of these. Select the white color and make sure it's somewhere. I'm just going to press twice so it's better visible. Change this blending mode overlay. So we're going to have some sun somewhere there. I'm just going to make it like this and stretch it out. So if we have this light starting here, so we need to make sure our sun is also like there. So I'm just going to move the background a little bit, because I imagine our sun is here. So this is fine, and need to brush some parts. So I'm just going to create a mask on this layer. Select the black brush. Select the normal brush again, soft round. And get rid of some of these. And also on the surface. So we only see it under the water. It's a little bit too much now, so I'm just gonna drop the opacity here. I think this is fine for now, and I want to blur out this background of this surface of the water, so I'm just going to select this layer, select the black brush, bring the hardness down, and while holding down shift, I'm just going to draw this line maybe twice so we don't see the end of this water. All right, let's add some bubbles. I'm going to do this in the wheel folder, so I'm just going to create a new layer on top of it. Go to the brushes, go to the water bubbles brushes, and let's see which one. Make sure the opacity is at 100 and the flow also, and just pick a white color. They're a little bit hard to see, so I'm going to press twice. And let's make them not too big. And I'm gonna duplicate it so you can see it better. Maybe even, I think twice was enough. Let's put this in a folder. This is bubbles. Let's make another folder. Let's create some more bubbles here. Maybe some here. Just make sure it stays in the water. Can make them smaller and bigger so you don't see a pattern here, and give and select another one. Okay, this one is a little bit too much, so I'm gonna create this on a new layer. I think those are too much for me. Just create some bubbles around it, especially here. Maybe a couple here. I think those here are a little bit too big, so I'm just gonna get rid some of those, so we don't have too much there. And also these. This is a bubbles too. I'm gonna edit this again. I feel it's a little bit too far away now, so selecting this mask again and bringing back some parts here, so it's a little bit closer to the camera. Like that, and now let's make some lighting here. Let's create the new folder, name this lighting. Create a new layer. Select this color and pick something from the sky and bring it up. Select a normal brush, bring the hardness down. Let's make a dot here. This will be a light. I'm gonna change this blending mode to screen here and make this bigger and flatten it like that. So hold down Alt and Shift and flatten it a little bit. So this will be our light, and let's duplicate this layer. So I'm just duplicate this and change the blending mode to overlay so we can create some light on the water. And we can flatten it like that. Let's see, we can move this. Behind. Oh. Just make sure it's above the wheel layer. Stretch it out like that. So I'm holding down Control and stretching it like that. And drop the opacity. It's a little bit too much now. This is fine for now. I'm gonna edit that later on to make it better. All right, now let's edit this wheel so we can create some darker and lighter areas. So I'm just gonna create a curves layer on top of the wheel. Make sure to select this so we only affect this wheel, and we don't need that. We want to edit this part, so only on the water, this part, and just gonna make it dark. Now select this, the mask of it, select the black brush and make these areas lighter because we have light here, so we need to make these lighter again. Also some here. So we only made this bottom part darker. All right, now let's create a new layer on top of it. Make sure it's on top of this layer and not this. So here, and it's filled with 50% gray. So we can do some dodge and burn here. Make sure to create a clipper mask so we only have this area. Change this to overlay. And select the dodge tool. Let's do some midtones around 35%, and let's make, maybe that's even too much, around 20%, Let's make these top parts lighter. Especially here where we have some sun coming in. It's a little bit too much now, so I'm gonna drop the opacity here. And select the burn tool. Start off with highlights. And do some areas darker. And then midtones, drop the exposure. And some shadows. So this was before and this is after. So now you have some darker areas and lighter areas. All right, now this water needs to be edited because it needs to get darker at the bottom. So just gonna double click it. Select gradient overlay. Select this one and make sure it's black on both sides. So I'm just selecting this and press again to copy it. Hold on this one and drag it underneath it so it disappears. Soft light. So now we have some darker areas at the bottom. A little bit more transparent in the water because he's way too much visible now. So I'm just dropping the opacity here. Now let's create some splashes here around this surface here. So I'm just gonna create a new layer and pick one of these brushes. Make sure you have white color and just click anywhere to make that. Let's make this a little bit bigger. And resize this. Think something like that. Looks a little bit more real. We can even add a couple more. Let's make this in a folder splashes. And create a new layer again and do some more of these. Right, not that one. Let's see. Just a couple of those things to make it look more real. I'm just gonna brush these parts away so it only stays in the water. Like that. Let's add a bunch of fish in this sea. So I'm gonna create a new folder. Call this fishes. Now I have all these PNG files here, so I don't have to waste time cutting out all these images. So I'm just gonna paste them one by one in this file. So the shark, another shark here. Don't forget to make smart objects so we don't ruin the quality of all these images. And let's do one more shark here. Smart object and resize this. I don't know yet where to place them. I'm just gonna put them like this for now and make sure they're all in this file. Now I want to make sure they all blend well in together, so Let's start with this yellow one. It's way too bright for underwater. So I'm just gonna create the your saturation layer. Make sure to press this and bring down all this saturation and select yellow and especially all that yellow. Get rid of all that yellow color in it. And let's drop the opacity here. Let's add this fishing boy. I'm gonna put this guy on this wheel, its nose. So let's go in this wheel folder, create a new layer, paste it, and make smart object again and resize this. Let's flip this, transform, flip horizontal, so it's facing that way. A little bit bigger. Now we can try to make the quality of this nose a little bit better. So I'm gonna select this layer, then go to filter, camera raw filter. Let's zoom in here so we can see it better and go to this and increase the sharpening like that. Right, that's better. And let's add a little bit of shadows here. So I'm gonna create a folder for it. This is boy. Create a new layer, drag it underneath the boy and select a normal brush. Bring the opacity all the way down to around 20 and the flow also. And just make like this little shadow. So this is before and this after. Maybe drop the opacity a little bit if it's too much. And let's remove some color from it. So I'm gonna create a hue saturation again here. Select this and bring this down. I think this is fine. Now we can even do some lighting here. So we have lights somewhere here. So we need this right part of this boy a little bit darker. So let's do some curves here. Make sure to place this again and bring down the highlights. Select the mask of it. Select the normal brush. Bring the opacity and flow up again and select the black color. And just brush this side lighter. A little bit of his hand here. Right, that's better already. And let's add some birds to this composition. So I'm just gonna use this one. You can easily remove the background with a magic wand tool here. So just select this background, press delete, and just put this in our file. Gonna create a folder here, birds. Make smart object again and resize it. Like that, and we can do the same for these. Right now, I'm gonna blur one bird out so we create some depth here. So I'm just gonna use this one and go to filter blur and Gaussian blur so we can create a little bit of depth in this image. And we need to get rid of this color. So I'm just gonna create hue and saturation here and drop all that color. And the same goes for all the other birds. Okay, now I want to use this side of this image so we can create some land on this whole composition, so I'm just gonna cut this out with a pen tool. Right now, it doesn't have to be precisely with all these leaves here and everything. Just gonna do it roughly like this and put this in our file. Create smart object. And just place it somewhere here so we can fill up this empty gap here. Now let's duplicate this, flip it vertical. All right, now I move some stuff around and put this cliff on the right side. I think this looks better. So I'm just gonna do some final corrections here. So color balance, give it a little bit more blue. Like that, and some curves as always to finish this whole thing. So we can increase this, and we can maybe even remove this lighting. I don't know, what, just check what you like best or make it bigger like that. And we can always make the quality a little bit better. So I'm just press Command or Control Alt Shift E to duplicate all the layers in one layer. Change this to Vivid Light. Go to Filter Other High Pass. And somewhere around one, maybe half. So we can see these details even better. So yeah, that is pretty much it for this one. Thanks for watching. Hope you learned something new again. And don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next video.